Good Chodesh Tammuz. You know, we were mentioning, and the Bnei Yisrael really spells this out, that this month, the Chush HaRe'iyah, which means our vision, and the Chush HaShmi'ah, listening, both of these senses were damaged. Damaged throughout the 40 days of the Meraglim. And we have to try to fix that as much as we can. Also, the Bnei Yisrael writes, Al Pi Kabbalah, as we mentioned, this first month of Tammuz is keneged the eye, and the month of Av is keneged the hearing, Shmia. It's keneged Ruvain, which is based on Kira, Re'ia, vision. Shimon is Shmia, it's keneged Shimon. Very, very deep stuff. There's also the Bnei Yisrael says that each one of the months has what's called Tzirufei Shemos, the permutations of Hashem's name. And actually, you're supposed to be Mechaven when you say Boruch Ata Hashem. Mekadesh Yisrael Asher Chadoshim and Musaf, to be mechaven, to think about the permutations of Hashem's names of that month specifically. This month, Tammuz, is the letters of, which are the Sefer Tevas of Echol Zeh, Einenu Shoive Li. The last letters spell out Echol Zeh, the Hei, Einenu, the Vav, Shoive, the Hei, and Li, then the Yud. Now, the order of those letters is actually Hashem's name exactly reversed. That's why the Bnei Yisrael said this month is filled with dinim, judgment. And we got to be able to switch it around to what's called mamtik din, sweet, and we don't want any judgments. So one of the ways is fixing our vision, and that's not to judge. And that's an incredible challenge. I'm going to share with you an incredible story. It's also the time of simchas, of weddings, and when it comes to any, not just a wedding, the Kava Yasha writes something frightening, but very powerful. And kedai to have in mind when a person is making a simcha, be it a wedding, be it a bris milah, be it a tnoim. And many times what happens is, the challenge is one mashulach comes, one ani comes, and you really want him out. So I'll tell you what the Kava Yasha says. It's based on a midrash, a story. It tells us how powerful, how we can't know. And in fact, he writes how important it is, based on the Zohar HaKadosh, to make sure that when we're making a simcha, we're taking care of aniyim, we're taking care of the poor, maybe to give actually a donation before, and to invite maybe aniyim. It's not so simple today. You don't know who's an ani. This person might be the richest guy. But to go out of our way to look and worry about someone, especially whether it's a Talmud Chacham, someone that really is in need of money, and to invite them and maybe go give them a check before we write the check for the simcha itself. Why? So based on the Midrash, the Kava Yasha says a story. There was once a kala, a lady, a young girl, and her father was wealthy, her parents were wealthy, and they married her off. And the next day the husband died. Nachamo. The next time she got married again, the husband by the morning was gone. Again, she married a third time. At this point, there was a chazaka, and she already decided after the third husband died, that's it. She's not going to get married. She's going to be an amana. Vayhi ayoyim, one day, this rich father, he had a brother, lived in a different country, and that brother had 10 kids, barely could make it. One day, and the father used to go with his son, and they went into the market, and then they brought back wood, and they barely made it, and this time, they had nothing. That day, the son saw the distress of his father. Davened to Hashem, he said, please help me out. And he begged permission from his father to go and visit his uncle, his rich uncle. Anyway, he went to his rich uncle. He showed up at his rich uncle, and the uncle was happy to see him, and the daughter was happy to see him, and I was happy to see him. Anyway, he told his sons. The uncle said, what would you like? And he said, listen, first swear that whatever I ask you, you're not gonna renege on. Anyway, the uncle said, no problem. And he said, I want to marry your daughter. And of course, it was an incredible shock. What do I mean, marry my daughter? No way. The last thing you want to do is marry my daughter, I tell you. Ask for anything else. All the money in the world, but don't ask for my daughter. Anyway, but the mindset, he already gave his word. And they decided they're going to get married. Fine. Finally came the day of the chasana. And right before the chasana, this young man that was getting married to this young girl who already had married, had taking care of three husbands, suddenly an old man showed up, and he told him that he was Eliyahu HaNavi. And he warned him, he said, listen, in every wedding, in every simcha, especially yours, the Mr. Sam, Sam, the Samech Mem, the one you don't, the angel of death, shows up actually with his wife Lilis, also someone we don't want to meet. And they are mekatrek, and they look to see if a person is only worried about themselves and not worried about Anim. He's going to show up and make sure that you take care of him. Make sure that he has what he needs. Make sure he has all the food that he needs. And Kachave, that's exactly what he did. He followed instructions. And when they saw an old miskin, an old poor person showed up, so this Chassan made sure to take care of him. And Mamish, a whole night, made sure to sit him down and make sure he has food. And that's what happened. End of the chasana, he went home with his kala, and the parents were so worried, and the whole night they were up, and they were checking, and they were making sure, and they were so happy to see that it was on. In the morning, they heard that there was still laughter, and they couldn't believe it, and that's what happened. The boy, Baruch Hashem, survived, and he lived happily ever after with this young girl, and was based on, as the Kaviyasha points out, to make sure that this, the miskenim, the anim, the people that we look at and we say, oh, I don't want them to be in my chasna, in my simcha, and we look at them, we never know in our vision what we're looking at and how much sometimes, like Chazal say, more than a poor person needs a rich person needs a poor person. Have an amazing Chodesh Tammuz.